Hello? 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 Do we live? We should do. We live! Good lord. That was a mess, wasn't it?
What is going on?
What's going on, Twatch? Why you broke? Why you broke? Two, like, what was it? It broke Wednesday as well, didn't it? How spooky. That was spooky. Hello everyone, who have we got in here? Yeah. Yeah, that was, sorry about last night. I thought I ended the stream, apparently I didn't. So, while I slept, you could have farmed- I hope you've all farmed your loot points. Hope you farmed your loot points and got everything ready. Much farming has had, excellent, that's what I like to see. Oh, you got no loot points! No loot points for anyone now, Twitch has killed them all. That's what you get. That's what you get for having, like, Void Chan has taken them from you or whatever. That's what you get for cheating. Hello everyone, hello, hello, who we got here then? Hello Fairwolf, hello Noble, hello Pumpkin, hello Avarice. Hello Froggy, hello Salinity. Void Champ Tets you for 2020, not for much longer. Oh, that was a bad time, so. Alright, well, fuck it. We're gonna do a little bit of music to start with, but since it's got completely fucked, so we're gonna start again. Alright. Let's just tweet that we're doing it a second. I'm nice like that. Bammo. Here we go. Twitch is working again. Let's tell Nelly. Right. There we go. Sorted. Hi. Yeah, I'm glad you guys enjoyed the win stream of last night. It was a special stream. It was one of my favourites. Did any loot bombs actually happen? Because I actually checked on Streamlabs in case anyone tried to do any sneakily, and it didn't look like anyone did, which is good, I guess. Because I would have been upset, and I wouldn't be like, thank you. And I'd have been like, no, I would have missed thanking people. I'd have been like, sad. Alright, let me get the controller sorted in a minute. Really? You actually did a loot? Wait, you did bombs? Streamlabs told me nothing happened. What? What the fuck? Hold on, let me check. How do I check, actually? Shit. Really? Thank you, by the way, Mr. Virai. Thank you very much for the 18 months, and on a tier 2, and for the lovely bot. You fine, fine person, you. Thank you. Right, let me load up Velvet's Magical Adventure a second. I need to work out how I can see what happened, I guess? I'm really sorry if I didn't get to obviously get a chance to thank you, but... Yeah, as far as this... Yeah, I'm looking now. And it literally goes from 20 hours ago... to 3 hours ago, to 1 minute ago, which is Mr. Virite. So it didn't pick anything up. Oh, I'm really... Okay. How do I check? Let me have a look on Twitch. Let's just double check a minute. I'm not sure where this would be under. Stream summary, maybe? Of Fridays. No, it doesn't pick anything up. It literally, it didn't even count as a, it didn't like count as a real stream. I can't see anything. Maybe it counts as Thursdays? Yeah, it must have done. It counts as Thursdays. There was 30 people in here from 3 AM to 5 AM. You mad bastards, a lot of you. Madness. A Hey Vera, did you boost up to tier 3? Oh dude, thank you so much! Man, that was amazing of you, thank you very much! Hey Mapes! Hey everyone, sorry, let me just try and... I'm trying to find out what happened last night, when, and where. I don't know if I can find out. New subscriptions? There we go. I think I can see them at... There was one at 4 a.m. One at 1:40 a.m. One at 12:35 a.m. Hey, Andy. Hey, Sean, thank you for the bits, man. Thank you very much. Apparently my stream didn't laugh. It went all fucking weird last night. Hold on, let me export the data. Stream session CSV. Shit, I don't have to write. Wait, there must be a way of me finding this. It won't show me bits either. Well, again, I can't see exactly who it was, so... Can everyone tell me who was there for each one? So, Spookums did some. Is that right? And Noble did some. Oh, do you reckon you can fish that out of the bot? Hey Spookums, I heard you did some thingies last night, mate. Thank you so much. I'm trying to find out what actually happened. I'm having a bit of trouble because nothing registered, apparently. Which one did we save? That one? This one? That one. Oh yeah, we sent the ship out, didn't we?
Take a look at this.
Tuna.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Yeah, I want to find out so I can thank people properly. Like, the idea of, like, not saying thank you for people who've done that, like, gives me fucking anxiety. I need to, like, find out who it was. Noble did 20 gift subs. A little bit later, he did 25 gift subs. Happy New Year. Thank you so much, Spookums. Oh, thank you very much, man. That's really kind of you. Happy New Year to you, man. And thank you very much, Noble. Do we send that back
Scout
out again?
Ship setting
there we
sail.
Go. Nice. Okay. Cool. Thank you very much for that, Spookums. That's really kind. I don't know if Noble's here, actually. I saw Noble pop in at the start. I don't know if they're still here, actually. Fuck, I'm going to have to, like, message them. Shit. Let me get into a battle. I need to, like, write a message up to Noble, then. There's some other ones in there as well. Hopefully, Mr. Vera can get out of the bot.
And you get a lewd. Everybody gets lewds.
It's lovely to see you though, Spookums. Thank you very much again, man. Do you have a nice New Year's?
Lewd.
Thank you, Silenci. Thank you very much. Oh, that's really kind of you. Thank you so much. Oh, what do we want to... Look. New Year gift sub! Thank you, Silenci! That's really, really kind. Thank you very much for the lovely bomb! Hope you're doing well yourself, and I hope you had a happy New Year! And thank you, Spookers! Thank you for 25!
Come on, really?
Oh, we got another friggin' hype train! We had one last night as well! Oh, good lord. Honestly, don't feel bad, Pumpkin. It's not your fault. Not your fault at all. Honestly, don't feel bad at all. You didn't do anything wrong at all. If anything, I feel bad the fact you stayed up, like eyeballing the stream. I feel really guilty about that. Actually, thank you for the biddies. Tis I, Ali. Thank you so much for the lovely sub to Hallow Him. Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Right, sorry, I need to write a thing out to Noble a minute. Give me 2 seconds.
Lewd.
Right, there we go. Thank you, Tizayali. Thank you very much again. Thank you again, Spookins, for the 25. It's always good to see you, and thank you again for last night, man. Avarice, thank you very much for the gift sub. The hype train. Yeah, sorry, I was just typing out to Noble there. Yeah, I imagine Kane would like to be leaving it on. Oops. I can see that. There we go. Right, let's get murdering some boars and shit while I, We're actually alive again. Yeah, Mr. Dad, hello. Thank you, Avarice, for the gift, sir. I can't believe we've got another hype train going on. Ah, there you are, Noble. Sorry, I just sent you a big long message. Apologies. I wasn't sure if you were here or not. Your style is really... Woo! Hype train! Woo! Choo-choo! Thank you, Azzy. Thank you very much for the biddings. Can't believe you guys kicked up a hype train again. Honestly, it sounds like you could have kicked up a hype train while I was asleep, which is not only fucking hilarious, but, like, bizarre, to say the least. Oh, you're mad. A lot of you are mad. Noble, thank you very much for all the gift subbing last night, mate. Thank you very, very much. You are extremely generous. Thank you, mate. Thank you, Sean. Thank you for the biddies. I woke up, right, to, like, a shitload of text messages from Linny, from Ollie, from Pumpkin, from Peggy, from... Oh, I got loads and loads and loads going, you left the stream on, by the way, is everything alright? I was like, oh god, I did what? What the fuck did I do? Thank you, Furry Wolf, thank you for the biddies. Right, we want to go down here and... Yeah, we want to go down this way then.
Wow. Those
thank
walls,
you, Furry Wolf.
They're so huge.
That's Logris, the capital of the Empire. They keep demons out by enclosing
thanks,
the
babes.
City
love
within
you too.
A great wall.
Humanity has achieved great things on the backs of slave Malakith.
I'm just glad I didn't, like,
you've been here before,
I didn't, like,
right?
Leave the stream on and, like, I don't know, go watch something unsavory, like hand-holding.
I was not who I am now.
I see. Tethered Malakith aren't even allowed the freedom to observe their surroundings.
No, you didn't cause anxiety by, like, the gift subs itself. I just, like... Like, the idea of me not thanking people just upsets me, and I was just like, I need to know. Like, normally it would have been fine, but I guess because it balked, I couldn't find out who gifted what. But now I know, I'm all good. So I want to say thank you again, Noble. Nah, honestly, I've said to you before, never be sorry for donating, man. Like, it's an incredibly generous thing to do, and
we'll
I'm really grateful.
We'll soon lose such freedom ourselves. Huh? We've reached the heart of the
thank
Empire
you very much, Noble. Love you, man.
Abbey. Soldiers and exorcists are stationed all around.
I think there's a
no
couple more I need to fish out. But hopefully
like
Mr. Varric can find it in the bottom.
I'm not looking for a place. All I need to find is Artorias.
Velvet, you're so sour.
That's it.
Why are you so sour? Yeah, so what I think happened is I left the... Oops, what are these? I hosted Rupert at the end of the stream, but forgot to end mine. So when he finished, it basically just defaulted back to my stream because it was still technically on. And that's when it, like, that's when it brought... Yeah, hype train right at the start. Seriously, guys, thank you so much. It was bizarrely fun to hang out with people in front of the back screen. I'm looking, right? Like, here. Hold on. Sorry, guys, you can see that. Like, I can see, not just new subscriptions there as well, but average viewers? 25, 26, 30, 20? I feel kind of sad I've missed out on this fucking party. It sounds fun. There's this, like, giant hanging out party going on. I wasn't there. I mean, I was there in spirit, I guess, but, you know. I was there in spirit, if that counts. Right, we want... I actually kind of want to... Phew. Fuck off, Wolf. Go away! Go away! Okay, now you can come. Now you can come. There we go. Nice. A good for another void stream. Do I need to make this now a thing? Do I need to, like, pretend to finish the stream and just go to sleep? Oops. Where am I going? This one. Tell me about it. I wish I hung out now. Honestly, though, I was a mixture between, like, really tired and a smidge tipsy from the booze. I've been up since, like, 6 a.m. that morning. So by the time midnight rolled around, I was fucking, like, basically half asleep. By the end of the stream coming along, I was like, yeah, guys, vampires are fucking great, you know? I just love vampires. That's it, Carl. You peaked. I don't know, I'm kind of glad that people had fun, even with, like, a weird void stream.
I wish I had power like that.
Does make me giggle. Right, are we done with, No, we haven't sucked everyone off yet. I need to see the aqua ring, but we haven't finished that one yet. You've done the fire ring now, okay. So chuck the void ring on. Calcite daggers. You're done with the amber waistcoat. Okay, put the calcite ring coat on then. You're done with the boots? Okay, cool. Alright. So what's over here then? I reckon we should have a good old fashioned nosy about everything around here. Oh shit. What time did the stream end? When I woke up and I saw my PC was on, it was about 8 o'clock in the morning. So two things happened. So I went to bed about 1 o'clock in the morning by the time I went to bed. I accidentally forgot to unset my alarm for work. So my alarm went off at 6 a.m. So I was like, oh Jesus fucking Christ, little fucking fuck, Sharon. So I was pretty dead there. And then I turned it off again. And got up at 8. And then I saw my phone had, like, I shit you not, like, 20 messages from people. And I was like, what the fuck? What the hell? What's going on? So, and I saw it, said, like, you left the stream on all night, what's going on? And I was like, oh shit. So I went downstairs and saw the PC was like, the PC was on the, do you really want to shut down? Because you're streaming. And I was like, yes, please, that'd be great. Fucking, what a fucking knob. Well, I'm glad you guys had fun, so. I just feel bad about, like, Pumpkin staying up late for like a million hours. Alright, let's kill these horrible animals. Yeah, at least I wasn't gonna be late for the imaginary work that didn't go on. Either way, I'm glad it all worked out. Once again, thank you very much for those who were doing lovely donations and gift subs last night. I'm gonna go through it later and I'm gonna have a proper nosy. I was actually worried. I actually got a little bit earlier. I was super, super worried that I'd been banned. Because when I went to go start the stream, my profile wasn't loading. None of my videos were there. The text was all missing. My avatar was missing. And all my about information was gone. And I was like, oh, fuck. Did me leaving on just kill the thing? I just thought, shit, I might actually have to... I might have to actually go message Twitch or something. Tell them it was an accident. Hey, Franz. We're not allowed to pass here yet, though. Yeah, but luckily it was just Twitch shitting itself, so I got away with it, which is kind of handy. Anyway, more importantly, back to the game. Oh god, I got stunned. That's weird, I should have been able to stun. Right, so what we're doing is we're trying to get into the city, but I'm murdering about every, Oh, Mio subscribed as well. Oh, that was nice of them. I don't know Mio's Discord. If I can message him on Twitch. Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try. Perfect mayhem! Damn, Spookums, you're really rocking on the night hours. Honestly, if anything had happened to my stream, it would have been nobody's fault. It would have been nobody's fault but my own, not calling it out. So I don't want anyone to feel bad. No sadness. No sadness, especially from the sheer amount of generosity that was going on last night. Again, thank you again, Mr. Verite, for the gift sub to the AFK streamer, which is hilarious. Alright, we got a treasure chest here, which is good. And it was very nice of my mods to keep an eye on things while I was away as well, so I appreciate both of you as well. Thanks, guys. Alright, I think that's everything. Oh no, we can probably go under this bridge, I want to say. Oh, good stuff. Good stuff, Playful. I'm glad it's working alright. Right, let's fuck this monkey from behind here. Let me rephrase that slightly. Let me kill this monkey from behind. Sounds slightly better. Alright guys, have we got any costume preferences for our lovely Velvy?
Not even worth my time.
Nice. Alright. Earth ring. Okay, we got a new ring. Is anyone done with rings who can totally... Velvy, you're done with the ring. What ring was that? Oh, it was an earth ring, which we've already got. Tragic. Alright. Yes, Sean. I did very much have a nice stream. We did some vampire and it was really fun. Very, very good time. Do you have a nice New Year's, dude? Oh yeah, they do some sort of like disco in the auction house places, don't they? Which is quite funny. Oh no, what's going on here? Shenanigans.
An inspection.
They won't inspect everyone. Just act natural.
Shit. Quick, guys, act natural.
Your face is all stiff.
I know.
Velvy, why is your face all stiff? I think this is the scene with the dove thing. If it is, this makes
you
me giggle.
In the black coat. Show me your documentation.
Madam, I'm a fucking pirate.
Well, your travel permit from the Abbey. Where is it?
Foolish girl, how many times have I told you? A magician's apprentice must wear a pleasant grin.
Yes.
Magician?
Verily, I present to you the traveling troupe of mischievous misfits known across the land as Mogilu's Menagerie.
Mogilu is a treasure.
For the ceremony?
Why, yes, indeed we are, my dear. Please pardon my uncouth apprentice. Girl, allay the good man's fears and show him the dove trick you've spent all these weeks on. Go to...
Huh? Oh, sorry, mistress. I forgot to prepare.
You pathetic little shirker! A proper performer is perpetually prepared!
It's fine. Doves flying around would be a nuisance.
No, this will not do. If you cannot summon a dove, then act like one.
The normal costume, yeah, I can call it.
A dove!
Coo-coo.
Coo coo.
Remember, Mogilu's Menagerie manufactures mirth. That was just a small sample for the good citizenry of Logris.
I think we just witnessed somebody die inside.
Move along.
Hey, Meta. You make a good dove, Velvet.
That was a fine ploy, Mogilu.
Well, don't expect tricks like that every day. Coo-coo. Oh, that murderous gaze! Coo-coo!
Those doves were amazing.
Just a crude trick. If anything, it just shows the capital's defenses are pathetic.
Is it buffering?
More like it shows how much confidence they have in those defenses.
Not for me,
how
there's no drops or
anything. How many soldiers are here, Lafayette?
The number of exorcists in the capital? At least 1,000. And two divisions of guards.
I'd expect no less from the capital. They're not careless. They're covered.
We need trains.
Might need to reload, Mr. God.
See how the citizens smile? To think they were fleeing from demons just a few years ago.
Coo-coo.
To hold an observance of this scale shows just how much peace their power has brought.
A peace paid for with Luffy's
velvet? Lewd.
Coo coo. Thank you very much, Noble. Dude, 1190. Mate, I just realized we missed the leet. We missed the leet number. When did it happen? Oh no. 1337. Where did it go? Oh, nice. Wait. Wait, I'm sorry. I can't do maths. I can't do maths. I'm sorry. I'm an idiot. Hang on a minute. 13. I meant 1137 for some reason in my head, but that made perfect sense. Noble, I just gave you like 300 subs, man. It's all good. I was like, wait, when did this happen? We need more sleep. I shouldn't have woken up at 6 o'clock in the morning. How do I maths? Y'all take it!
Right now, Prince Percival is the one ruling Midgand.
Thank you,
He's
Cap!
The Crown Prince?
Lewd.
The Crown Prince? What happened to the king?
Thank you very much, Cap! Appreciate the gift, sir, dude. How are you?
Draw from public life and leave the kingdom to Prince Percival. He declared that a new way of thinking was needed to save the world from this crisis.
This king sounds like quite the guy.
Prince Percival is incredible, too.
Fucking Prince Percival.
He's following in the footsteps of the king by working hand in hand with Lord Artorias in the Abbey. As long as we have Lord Artorias and Prince Percival, the future of Midgand is bright. Ask anyone.
Got it. So all of Midgand is on Artorias' side.
That doesn't mean you can kill everyone, Velvet. It's not very feasible. Tis I, Ali. Thank you very much for the 100. The 100 little bitties. Thank you very much. That's 100 little bits of lewd. Pee-pee. Vui-vui. No, Noble. You should add meals to your budget. You should get curry. Noble, you should get another curry.
The Abbey's job is getting
you should get
harder
two more curries.
We've all got to give them our full support.
Is this a costume you meant, by the way, Pumpkin?
Let's backtrack a bit. Just what sort of organization is this, Abbey?
You're kidding me. How do you not even know that?
The Abbey is part of Midgand's Church of the Empyreans. Originally, it was an order of paladins and warrior priests devoted to exorcising
What's a paladin?
Evil.
Yeah. The Abbey's official name is the Exorcist Abbey of the Church.
8 gold coins?
Midgand.
How much is that?
Nowadays, its members are all called exorcists.
I'm impressed. You've done your research.
So basically, they're just one branch of the church, right? For a
side what courage do you have, Noble?
They don't really strike me as humble.
Of course not. The High Priest entrusted all his power to the Abbey's leader, Lord Artorias. He's effectively retired.
So the Abbey's leader is at the top of the entire church.
That's not all. The Prince also gave Lord Artorias
That's nice, isn't it?
Over all military and government affairs during the crisis.
Lord Artorias commands Midgard now, and has formed a new theocracy to combat the demon blight.
And that is the origin of the Holy Midgand Empire. The Abbey is its foundation, and its ray of hope.
Wow, okay, got it. The Abbey's a big deal.
Jeez, alright, fine. Aw, chicken tikka masala is lovely. I love spicy chickpeas. I forget what they're called. It's another Indian, like, I think it's like a starter. It's like spicy chickpeas in like a sort of pastry package they do. Really nice. Ooh. Butter chicken and tikka masala. Oh, that sounds really nice. That sounds really nice. I always thought Balti's quite nice as well. How are we doing for, everything? Oh, fine. I guess we should save it. If the stream early this morning was unmanned, does that mean hand-holding bot are there filthy way with everyone in the chat? Yes, the hand-holding bot went crazy, probably. Bot was like, the boss isn't here. T- time to handhold everybody. Disgusting. We need to beat it. I told her to shut it, did you, Stan? Did you sort the bot out? Oh, you fuck it up. Samosas? No, not samosas, no. They're not samosas, they're, I don't know what they are. They're like, I can't think of the right word. Oh, we should talk to,
Mommy, when's the prince gonna talk? The exorcists are coming too, right?
Gross.
I'm sure they will, dear.
That's disgusting.
People are saying it's going to be a very important announcement about the Abbey.
I want to see the exorcists! We need to thank them for saving us from the demons!
You're right. We all have to show them our gratitude and help them however we can.
Yeah!
Holy shit, Cap!
I'll follow the rules, too. I won't be selfish.
They sure are popular.
Because these people don't know the truth.
Velvet, don't ruin the moment. Thank you so much, Cap!
Exorcists are fighting the demons they themselves cannot. That's why the people support the exorcists.
Thank you so much for the 3,000! Holy crap! Let's ring in the new year with extreme loot!
Yay!
Extreme loot! Wait. Velvet jiggles when we do that. Velvet's helping with the loot. Good work, Velvet. Jiggle away. Good stuff. Desi Chana? I don't think it is. No, that doesn't sound right. That doesn't sound right. I need to have a look. They do them in the local shop, actually. I need to see if I can fish them out. Thank you, Cap. Did you have a nice new year yourself? Thank you so much for those biddies. You that look like I can use some new armor? What are you, my mother? Fuck off, mate. I mean, I might, to be fair. Right, let's get rid of the beast. Let's get rid of that one. Disassembling all the stuff because we got tons of shit. Who needs all this stuff? Not I, says I. Seriously, I don't need all this stuff. There we go. Alright. I actually don't need any of this stuff, probably. Natural waistcoat. Oh, alright, we'll get one of those. A wind ring? Oh, we definitely need more rings. Calcite blade. Oh, we're using that at the moment. Okay. Alright. I went to bed early for New Year's because I stayed up too late the night before raiding World Classic. What were you raiding? What boss were you raiding? Or what bosses, I should say. So, Earth Ring, we'll do the Wind Ring. I actually really like Velvy's hair like that. Looks nice. Okay, is anyone else full on... Okay, that's fine. Just want to make sure I'm not capped out. Amber Boots. We need more hard shoes if I can find them, actually. That would be quite useful, wouldn't it? Okay, let's have a quick look at that. They're not selling any hard... They're selling some calcite boots, though. Funky. Let's get some of those. Okay, what else can we do? Aphrodite sash? Ooh. Calcite talent. I'm actually out of calcite fragments, which is unhelpful. Okay, we can upgrade the rings. And the shoes look fine. Okay, that's fine. Nax! Oh, nice! Construct Spider and a Noth. Oh, I actually raided Nax back in the day at level 60. And Inspector Resuvius. We had to tank him with rogues. So you'd have two priests mind control them. And they had to have a certain amount of, like, I want to say spell hit. Or something like that. So that their mind controls missed less. And then if that went wrong, the rogue would step in because they would be highest on the threat meter and have to evasion tank. But it was 50% chance of getting hit, so of course you'd hope the best. Kabuli? No, I don't think it is that either. Tell you what, mate, I'm going to go into the shop probably tomorrow. If I find out what it is, I'll have a look. Yeah, bring out the rogue strat. It was awesome. That's how we used to do it. We used to do it and make sure you're dressed up like a furbolg with the furbolg stick. You're watching Song Go for Yakuza 0 for the first time on YouTube, and you enjoy the surprise when they're... Oh, Mr. Shakedown, what, and they get fucking absolutely dismantled. Yeah, it's terrifying, isn't it? Oh, that was rubbish. Oh, we got a pirate flag.
Scout ship set.
What's the pirate flag on? Yes, I mean, Phasmophobia is really good. Jag very kindly gifted to me ages ago, and I've very selfishly not played it. So it'd be fun to do that. There we go. Speaking of Yakuza, we'll probably do some Jacuzzi tomorrow, if everyone's game. So we've got some Jacuzzi to do. Oh god, I don't remember that actually, Cat. That's crazy. Oh, cat. Meow. Wait, I didn't get anything? What a fucking scam. Shitty cat. Sure, Froggy, that sounds good. Donk. That shadow resisting cap is hilarious though. I can totally believe that's how it worked as well. That's just it's so bullshit and stupid, I can totally believe. Oh, are we not supposed to go through this way yet, maybe? We're drilling for a parade ceremony. You can watch as long as you stay out of the way, right? I don't think we actually do much in town. Oh, a cute waitress. I wonder if the soldier who flirted may be taking part. You seem good enough, lad, but I'd stay away if I were you. With a soldier, you never know what tomorrow may bring. Turn back, no? I think we're going the other way. I played a bit of the new expansion. I liked it, but didn't like it. No, that's not fair. I really did like it, but it wasn't holding my attention enough that I kept playing it. When Final Fantasy's patch came out, I just went straight back to 14. It just didn't keep me going. Oh, my nose is sore. I had this whacking nosebleed this morning as well. It all happened this morning. Infinite void streams, nosebleeds, waking up early.
Listen to those cheers. The royals sure have these folks in line.
Great, Magilu.
May I have your attention? It is I, Percival Asgard, Crown Prince of the Midgard.
Fun fact, the Asgard ruins are a place in Tales of Symphonia. There you go. Alright, sorry, that's me done.
Empire. His Majesty, my father, and I are pleased to celebrate with you on this auspicious day.
Oh, nice. Where is he?
The ceremony started. It'll be impossible to slip in now.
I haven't been following the story at all. What do I need to know? Okay, the very, very quick to bring you up to speed. What has happened thus far? Velvet, our interestingly dressed protagonist, has essentially, her brother was killed and sacrificed into an abyss, a pit, by essentially her brother-in-law, who was married to Velvet's brother-in-law, who was married to her sister. Her sister died 5 years previous as well. Essentially, that guy, Artorias, his name was, her brother-in-law, looked after everything, you know, the entire family for them. He was a surrogate dad as well, for all intents and purposes, you know. He betrayed her and left her for dead as well. She ended up in the pit as well. Her hand got consumed, and she ended up turning into a demon in the pit. It didn't kill her, and she got locked away in prison for 3 years. Artorias! Yeah, Dark Souls, seriously. What is it with Artorias and being Gribbles? Anyway, so Velvet spent the last 3 years in prison just being fed demons just so you can eat. Because she eats demons, or eats anything really with her demon hand. She can eat everything. That's how she survives. And now she did a prison break and is attempting to find Artorias and kill him for revenge. That is her sole purpose. This is not a happy-go-lucky RPG. This is a I want my revenge and want to fucking murder him. That's the general gist, and we're in the city looking for him now.
Our kingdom faced an existential threat, both from demons and the terrible spread of demon light.
Oops.
However, one man raised a miraculous sword and stood so that the body and soul of the land would not be lost.
You can climb up if you want, but attacking now would be suicide.
And the name Bob's of Virginia, that exactly. man was Artorias Colbrand.
Artorias! 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 Artorias!
Ollie's got the sensible idea.
None here, I trust, are unfamiliar with Artorias' noble act. To bring us...
Basically, Artorias, just for context, Artorias took everything from Velvet. The little brother she loved. Essentially himself. The surrogate dad that she, you know, that she ended up having. The brother that she had. You know, the foster, you know, the stepbrother, the brother-in-law that she had as well, that she relied on him. Everything she had was taken from her that night. And all the entire village died. She ended up killing them all as they turned into demons. Just dropping in to add my name to your view account. Well, that's very nice of you, the Wanderer Uncle. Hello. Happy New Year.
Salvation from demons. He sacrificed everything.
But he's a murderer.
Why are you checking your bank, Mr. Barrett? What's up, dude?
He called Lord Inovinat, one of the five Imperiums, and blessed us with the strength of the Malachi.
But he's a murderer!
He Velvy. Serves as a shining beacon of reason in this world of turmoil. And reason is what binds us.
But you killed him. You took everything.
Oh, okay. Nice.
So raise poor your Velvet. Voices in praise to Artorias' devoted work.
Look at that fucking claw hand of hers.
Who purifies evil and guides our flock. Let us call him our shepherd.
Shepherd Artorias. Shepherd.
Velvet's rage makes her the most powerful. Literally, she's too angry to die. Velvet, in demon form, cannot get killed. Her HP cannot go below 1.
Even though the world was filled with suffering, I had to... ask something tremendous of you all. I entrusted you
Velvet ended up in the opening.
I asked you...
Sorry, apologies, I don't want to talk over Artorias. Velvet ended up in the opening, which turned her into a demon. The same opening that killed her brother. It tore off her arm, and she gained a demon arm. But also, it transformed her as well. And it's sapping her humanity. A fair bit of our party are demons. We got Velvet and Rokuro are demons. Aizen is a spirit. Margaloo is an idiot. And the other two we haven't met yet. Oh no, we have. Lafisa is a spirit as well, along with Aizen.
Spell calamity is one forged from unshaking reason and the iron will to do what must be done.
She kind of zero should start
and
a club.
That
agreed.
Very blade stands ready before all of us today. I offer my body and my life.
Indeed. Exactly. That's a good point, Ollie. In Zestaria, same costume as well, pretty much, we play as a guy called Soray. In fact, because it's relevant, I'm going to find a picture in a minute and show you. It's not exactly the same, but you'll see what I mean in a sec. No, I don't want to save it with the smut. I want to save it with the pictures. It's very important. Weenie, Happy New Year. Don't play unless you download the restored content from the shop. Oh, Noble, thank you. I've never played that before. I'm looking forward to that. Oh, Noble just gifted me Knights of the Old Republic 2. I've heard nothing but really good things about that. Thank you very much, man. That's very kind of you. Thank you. I am... Oh, that's exciting. I'm looking forward to that. Right, where's Saray? Ah, here you go. This is Saray. You can see he's got a very similar outfit and sort of look and colour scheme to Artorias. And he's also got the same emblems, the feathers, which is the emblem of the shepherd. So yeah, there you go. More you know. Sorry, let me get everything back up and running. There we go.
In service to the people of this great land.
Thank you very much, Noble.
With the blessings of the Imperium Innominat, I will guide you to a world without calamity. And this world's suffering will be nothing but a distant memory.
We could stream Knights of the Old Republic at some point. I think that'd be quite fun to do, actually. Find out how one girl's anger. Oh. Head pats.
You're the one who killed Lafayette.
What?
Velvet, your hand's leaking. That's what my hand's doing right now as well. I feel
sympathy. Shepherd Artorias. That's who you're after?
Aw, and here I was hoping you'd just straight up pounce on him.
Lewd.
That would be certain death. No, I need a sword of reason and will. That's the only thing that can kill him.
Killing Lord Artorias? Playing it safe? Boring! Regrettably, it is at this juncture we go our separate ways. I've got a bit of hunting to do.
No one's stopping you.
Goodbye. Farewell! May your days be fruitful and your nights tormented!
Thanks, Magaloo.
If our enemy's calling himself a shepherd, he won't be going into hiding. Let's take this slowly.
The old man behind him. Melchior, I take it?
Yeah.
Let's gather information on these people. If we know what they're planning, we can find a weakness.
They're the most powerful men in the land. If we're going to look into them, we need to leave.
Yeah, Margaloo just vanishes again. Isaac, she does for a little bit.
Do you have any underworld contacts in the capital itself? Like your friend at the...
No, Cap. That small child is... Velvet, he was originally called Malachim Number 2. However, when he was falling off of the bridge we were fighting a dungeon in, she cried out for Lafayette because he reminds her of her brother, and now that's what she calls him. That's his name now. Simply because, he reminds her of her Lafayette as well.
Port.
I don't go.
Oh, happy birthday for tomorrow, Stan!
But Ifrid has close ties to a shadow guild, a tavern in the city run by an old man called Baskerville.
Baskerville.
Serves as a front for them.
A shadow guild. Those sorts of things actually exist.
That settles it. Let's head to that tavern. They'll have food, I'm sure.
Why not?
Come on, Velvet. Velvet is in a very, very, very bad place mentally.
My stomach made a weird noise.
That's another sign that you're alive.
She's not dealing with her problems. Essentially, she's doing the classic thing. She's doing the classic thing of, I have some terrible issues I need to resolve, but I'm going to shove them under the carpet. And you look at the carpet, and the carpet's like elephant-sized, and it's bulging. She's like, and it's fine.
Full force to see the shepherd's inauguration, weren't they?
What about that guy you're after? Was he there?
What, and have to stand around looking all proper? Nah, that's not his style.
But I thought he was one of the top exorcists.
That wouldn't matter to him.
Huh. All right.
Actually, Velvet, speaking of the shepherd, I noticed he wasn't using his right arm. Was he hurt or something?
Seriously, yeah. The carpet's gone.
He was badly wounded a long time ago. He lost the use of his sword arm.
That's what I figured.
But don't get the wrong idea. He's still a master swordsman with his left arm.
I can tell that from the way he moves. His movements are steady and measured, and his chi is centered below his navel.
That's his penis. Huh?
Why does that matter?
Some people say that all the body's spiritual energy gathers in a place about 2 finger widths below the navel.
Penis.
Even when he appears to be in a state of total peace, his guard is never down. He's a formidable adversary. And I think I know why my target has placed himself at Artorias's side. Because now I want to take Artorias down too.
Hey, Murloc, Happy New Year, dude. Yes, Stan, what's your plans for tomorrow, my man? Right, let's book our Velvy. My little Velvet couldn't possibly be this angry. Right, let's move her back into the city. I don't think there's anything... Ah! Here. The nice thing, by the way, about the expeditions, you know that the ship is coming and going, that is in real time. So if you send the ship off and go have lunch for half an hour, come back, load the game up, it'll come back in half an hour. It'll do that. Which is really quite handy. And it goes through cutscenes and everything. You know, it's literally just 30 minutes of real time.
So. Savior of mankind.
Hello, Hot Carl. How you doing? Through the darkness. Haven't seen you in a bit.
What an appropriate title for Lord Artorias.
Shut the fuck up.
I believe in him. As long as we have Shepherd Artorias, we'll make it through this era of disaster.
Shepherd Artorias?
How pompous can you get?
Artorias has already seized control of all religious and secular power in Midgard.
Velvet just angrily, like,
he's taken on
seized.
This new title, he's no longer just
what
an
are you
authority
tonight,
figure. He's become the very hope of the masses. A dangerous opponent indeed.
After seeing that, will you still fight him?
Of course I will. He could be a god for all I care. I'll have my vengeance. No matter what.
Velvet the God Killer. I can see it. Or Yakuza. For those who want to see some Yakuza 7, I believe is the newest Yakuza, Ollie will be streaming it very shortly. Ollie, it's twitch.tv/OllieDag. So if you want to have a nosy of that, that'll be, what, 5-10 minutes? Is that Ollie?
What'll it be?
Some food for the boy.
Mabo curry is our specialty. It takes a week to stew properly.
What the fuck kind
Mabo
of curry takes
curry.
A week?
Some of that, then. Say, do you know a man named Baskerville? I heard we might find him here.
Close to the 30-ish. All right. Scoundrel in about half an hour, then, against the rules of the Abbey. Ollie will be streaming.
They executed
nice.
Long ago.
Oh.
Good stuff, Ollie. Well, best of luck with the stream, mate. Here we go, all right?
Velvet, this Mabo curry is amazing.
Aw. He's cute, isn't he? Velvet's just sourly.
You get along so well. Is he your brother?
No.
No, he wouldn't be, would he? After all, your brother was murdered before your eyes.
How do you know that?
The shadows watch those who flinch from the light.
So the guild is still active, even after Baskerville's arrest?
That old lady was cold.
That's right. Just like how Eifried's crew continues their piracy, even without their captain.
So you're the contact?
What may I help you with?
The curry, please.
I want to know what Artorias is planning.
Information such as that?
One Mabo curry for Noble, please.
I have here a list of jobs. Not one remotely legal.
We'll get some prickle ball for,
And I'll tell you what you
spookums.
Want to know.
What's been keeping you busy? Ah, I get that, Hot Call, I really do. Well, it's good to see you, man. I'm glad you're here. Take on which request? Destroy goods, search for a missing man, fall down ambush. Alright, guys, what should we do? Which one do we want to do? Take your pick. Missing man, foil, search. So we got 2 for missing man. 3 for 4, missing man, 3 for missing man, okay. Next one takes it. Destroy goods. Foil away. Alright. Let's do it. Stop an ambush at the Royal Medical Society. Alright.
Take this with you as documentation. It's fake, but it's a good
one. We'll end up doing most of them anyway. Hey, Gorster. LM.
It's registered to Mogulu's Menagerie.
Oh? Was that not the name you gave to the guard at the gate?
Coo! Coo!
I can see you're a group to be reckoned with.
Coo!
Report back here once you're finished. However, be aware that should you fail...
Then this conversation never took place. Got it. I'll cause you no trouble.
I really like that hairstyle with,
I appreciate your understanding.
With Velvy.
You're welcome to stay the night, free of charge. Forget about work until the morning comes.
Gross.
Right. You're missing Captain Eifried.
Coom.
The captain has done much toward our viability. I promise that I'll share anything I hear about him.
Look at the size
of
those fucking ice. Damn.
Thanks. All we know is there was a pendulum on the ground at the last place he was seen. And that Legate Melchior is connected to the captain's disappearance. How? We don't know.
It's a mystery. We should change Rokuru's costume around as well. We should change Aizen Rokuru's a little bit. Wait, when did I give Aizen a cowboy hat? When did that happen? I don't remember doing that.
Sounds like you've got problems of your own. Do you really have time to take on ours as well?
I could ask you why you've tied yourself up with Velvet.
Me? I've got a debt to repay. Without her, there's no way I'd have ever found my blade.
These two need to bang already.
A demon repaying a debt? Ridiculous.
As ridiculous as a pirate Moloch, you think? No matter how you look at it, there's nothing reasonable about our rogue existence.
That's some good clipping.
And in this brave new world governed by reason, a rogue can either rage and become a monster like me, or...
Well, they can tank in Nax Amorous.
...together with others.
Oh.
Like a ship full of pirates, perhaps.
Exactly. I admire Velvet's courage, squaring off against the whole world on her own. Few can accomplish that. It takes strength. Real strength. And I'm curious where it comes from.
So you're doing it for yourself after all?
Is that so wrong?
No. I'm the same. I need allies on my side. With the strength and courage to combat.
Honestly, Velvet needs a good hug.
Order imposed by the Abbey.
Nax tank life, agreed.
Who's willing to
gotta do that evasion tanking.
Creed folly of Ifrid's pirates. Has to be an even bigger fool than we are.
I love these two are getting drunk.
So I'm like you.
And like just yapping away.
I want to know how deep her foolishness goes.
They just like the cleavage. That's the real
reason. She'd kill you if she heard that, you know.
It's a compliment. Fools that big aren't born every day.
Here, try some pirate whiskey.
Uh-huh. And I imagine your dear Captain Ifrit is much the same.
Aye. That man flies his full flag proudly.
Look at this fine bromance going on. This is some good shit. I gotta be honest, I do love me some good old good bromances in games. That's actually why I really liked
The Shepherd Artorias.
FF15.
He's got the populace eating from the palm of his hand.
Gross.
I wonder. Just how deeply will the fangs of our would-be tragic heroine scar this broken world of ours? I've got a traitor to find, but in the meantime, this should be a good show.
Hey, Jim Earth. Sorry, Spookums. Oh, we can now cook some curry, can we? Let's have a look. Ooh, what should we do? Oh, let's... Actually, we can do... We haven't got enough for the curry, but we can do some fresh fish. Here, Velvet, you do it.
Food's ready. It's nothing special.
Velvet, it's fine. Used to cook for your little brother. It'll be fine. Stop being so sour.
A kind face for such a hard woman.
She knew about me and our cover. She's got ears everywhere.
And that's not all. She called the papers fake, but they're not.
So she's got spies working on the inside, too.
I heard that her predecessor, Baskerville, was a monument against authority.
Hey, Tunic!
To think he was right, executed.
Dude.
They've lost
Happy
their
New Year, man.
But remain unconquered. Not an organization to trifle with.
I know, they
that's
should be like a romance,
to
right,
take
Noble?
On the Abbey. We'd better succeed on our missions, and not just to get the information we need.
Yeah. Besides, I'd like to get another of those drinks, too.
You're a man of taste.
That no, Noble. In your endo.
You'd better work hard, too, if you want more Mabo curry.
I will.
I love that we're paying Lafayette in curry. To be honest, I'd work for a curry. What sort of payment would you like for doing this? Yeah, you know, curry. Actually, jokes aside, I do like, working for breakfast at work, if people say, will you help me fix my laptop, like, you know, like a non-work laptop, so they bring it over and they say, like, what payment do you want? I was like, just buy me breakfast, that'd be fine. Play the serving game. Are you ready? Serving game rules. This is a game where you try to bring the right orders to the customers. Customers who are waiting to have their orders taken will have speech balloons over their head. Start by taking their orders. Next, head over to the counter and collect the proper orders. If you pick up the wrong order, you can try and get rid of it by X and Y. Lastly, take the right orders to the right customers. Each time you do, it will count as a successful order. If you bring a customer the wrong order or make them wait too long, they will get angry, and it will count as a failed order. Each complete order, whether success or failure, will count towards the required amount of orders to complete each stage. You need to be careful, you're only allowed to a limited number of fails. Each game is played in a series of three stages. When you finish a stage, you can choose whether to carry on. If you quit it, you'll be rewarded with TL coins. If you continue to play, you'll get to the next stage. Okay. The key is this game is watching carefully for the customer's orders, while working efficiently. Okay. Let's try it. Here we go. I want some fruitcake. Fruitcake. Soul food. Give me some Mabo curry. Nice. Devour. I want some pudding. All right. Yeah. Nice. He zoom, but more importantly, he holds him. Hey, Cav. You get some curry or something, T-Neck? Hello, Mega Hassie. Hey, Kiko, thank you very much for the raid. Hey, New Gundam. Hey, Tech Dragon. We're doing a little mini game. Thanks for the raid. How did your, did you notice Twitch going down, by the way, in the middle of your stream? Hey, Deus Phoenix. What do you want? Give me some fine, mild curry. What about you, sir? What are you after? The chat died. Pudding. You want some pudding? Alright, let's do it. We're currently giving food to people, because, you know, saving the world, doing food. Hey, Carl. Risotto? I don't even know how to spell it. Fruitcake. Fruitcake! Tina, if you had to pick a curry, what curry would it be? Exactly, you cannot save the world in an empty stomach. That's very important. I don't know what happened to it, to be honest, Noble. It's fucking weird. Oh, what's that, Dan? Something? What are you linking me? Sorry. Happy New Horizons. Oh, that's so cute! Is that actually... That's from the actual Doom one. That's so good. Aw, that's cute. Oh, that's great. Doom! Oops, sorry, I need to click on them. There we go. Oops. Pudding. Come on, pick, pick, pick! Alright, fruitcake. Homemade bread? Oh, homemade bread, I bet it smells amazing. How did your trip to Canada go, Kigo? Did you make it? Savory egg custard. Disgusting. Penang curry? Oh, Penang is so nice. Red Thai Penang pudding and mild curry, okay? Pudding, mild curry. You had Carl? Wait, Carl, were you in, were you going to Canada? You never had a curry? What, Tunic? You've never had curry? Oh my god, we need to fix that. You're so earnest and innocent, it hurts. Keep this up and you'll think you have your very own fan club. Put this uniform and keep it. Laffy has got a serving clothes. Nice. Here's a nice bow tie to go with your uniform. Good work. Velvet can now do it as well. Look at Velvet's serving costume. You ready? So we got pudding, peach pie. Pudding, peach pie. Pudding, peach pie. There we go. I like Velvet's one, actually. Tofu salad. Where's that? Oh, it's right at the top. Mabo curry. Hot Carl was there in spirit. You got to Canada and then. I'm glad you made it. Banana and fruitcake. Okay. Banana, fruitcake. Hey, Max. There is so many different curries. It's ridiculous. The man who shouts Carl a lot and then Carl. Carl, there's so many Carls. We've got, actually got a lot of Carls here. Kiko had a Carl. We've got a Carl and a hot Carl. Have we got any additional Carls? How many Carls can we actually get up to tonight? Alright, T-Nick. Safe trip home, mate. Safe trip home. Can you have a curry on the way back? Right, let's... We're not going to save the world until we get Velvet's out for... It's very important. What are you after? Salmon and veg. Okay. Tofu. Mild curry. Tofu. Mild curry. Peach pie. Okay. Tofu. Oh, what do you want? Tofu and pudding. Okay. Tofu, pudding. What are you after? Mild curry. Peach pie. Catch you later, Kiko. Thank you very much for the raid. Much appreciated. For those who are sticking around, this is called Tales of Berseria, if you know the game. Well, you don't need to explain it, obviously. If you don't know the game, it is a it's an RPG with real-time combat. It's quite a serious dour affair, but we're going to make it fun by chucking Velvet in lewd costumes and the boys in lewd costumes. It's going to be good times. You want pudding, do you? Okay. Pudding. What do you want? Lasagna. Oh, what do you want? So we've got lasagna and seafood salad. Okay, so first of all, lasagna and seafood salad. Mild curry and fruitcake. Okay, so mild curry and fruitcake. And you want peach pie, okay. So you want tofu, consume. So tofu and whatever coom is. I got even coom. Okay, tofu and coom. And you want mild curry and pudding. Nice. We've gotten some coom. That dude's eating, like, shitloads of pies. Consume? No, it's called coom. You can keep the uniform. Nice. Good stuff. Oh, the expedition's come back. Alright, what do we get? Yeah, nice. We got tuna. The Diomel Islands. These islands are home to a legend of two mysterious twins. Any structures crumbled to dust long ago, and only surviving relics of clothing made from an unknown material. That's from one of the Tales games. I'm not sure which one that is, actually. Not sure which one. Oh, we can't go yet. Okay, we have to go back there.
Scout ship setting sail.
Alright, Velvy. Let's have a look at your costume, then. Oh, serving clothes. Hey, look at that. Very fancy. Oh, let's change the voices over as well. What we got for you, Luffy? Yeah, you're gonna be a waiter for a bit. Rokuru. Nice, you're gonna be, Ludger. Like it. Perfect. Nice. Good shit.
So, somebody means Dapper. To ambush the Royal Medical Society on the Danann Highway.
The Royal Medical Society is a group of doctors that travel around.
Honestly, Deus Phoenix is one of the best ones.
They're funded
it's
by donations given by ordinary folk.
Why would anyone attack them?
Don't ask me. Some people are just twisted.
And why would an underworld group defend them?
Who knows? Something to do with the attackers, perhaps?
What other Tales games have I played? I have played... So, in order as well. Tales of Phantasia. Tales of Symphonia. Tales of Eternia. Tales of the Abyss. Tales of Vesperia. Tales of Tales of Graces. Tales of Xillia 1. Tales of Xillia 2. Tales of Zestaria, Tales of Berseria. I don't think I've missed any. Why am I guessing? I've got them all behind me, right? No, they're downstairs. Ugh, useless. I've played most of them that's come out in Europe. I have Tales of Hearts R on the Vita. It's still sealed. I never played it, weirdly enough. I never played my Vita much.
That ceremony was simply fantastic. Lord Artorias's speech was brilliant, of course, but Prince Percival was really something.
Shut the fuck up, Prince Percival.
He raises up Artorias to help the country and its people, then willingly steps
They're
down.
Amazing, Deus Ex.
Now that's what I call a king.
You think so? Well, to me,
Mila Maxwell's great.
He may look that way, but he has a great inner strength.
He's yeah, seriously, Emmy, I know what you mean.
And a leader since he was young.
I'm not even
His
sure I know what Charger is.
Is falconry, but sadly, I hear he hasn't had the time for it lately.
You seem like a big supporter of his.
Well, he's got two younger brothers, but just between you and me, they're dolts.
Dolts?
Worse, they hang with a bad crowd. If anything were to happen to Prince Percival, the future of Midgand would be bleak.
I see. So everyone's hopes are riding on him, then.
Which means Midgand's vulnerable without him.
It'd be nice if they re-release Hearts on Switch. Honestly, Abyss needs to come out on Switch. That would help. That would help. One thing that I love that Tales does, by the way, they always do more houses and more stuff in the distance to make it look like the city is bigger than the explorable space. It's really, really good for, what's the right word? For immersion, I find. Because, like, a lot of RPG towns are obviously quite small because, you know, realistic sizes and whatnot for exploration. But when you actually have a more stuff visible, I find that's great. I really like that.
He may be the shepherd now, but no one knows who he was before the advent or what he did.
I know who he was.
They don't.
But he showed up one day with a Malak in tow, routed the demons, and formed a band of skilled young
Genshin Impact
exorcists.
Is amazing. I
that
love it.
Sounds pretty suspicious.
I play it every day.
Right? But the kingdom readily acknowledged his abilities and his conviction, and threw its full support behind him.
Maybe he plans on usurping power.
What do you mean, J-Stank, sorry?
Not likely. He's worked tirelessly to rebuild the church and state, and to shore up the royal family's position.
Lining his pockets from the state coffers, then?
Not the slightest chance. Rather, he's got all the other higher-ups worried he's working himself to death.
Then what's he after?
Maybe there is no ulterior motive. Maybe he
What's
is our shepherd.
Malak? What's Malak in Star Wars?
Case, if he hadn't shown up when he did 3 years ago, Midgand would be a smoking ruin.
Why does everyone say the shepherd is amazing? Knights of the Old Republic. Okay. Is that Darth Malak?
Greetings, Magilu's Menagerie. You've come to exactly the right place.
You must be a Bloodwing.
Coo!
What do you want?
You already know about the Code Red demons, right?
The really strong demons the Abbey wants gone? Yeah.
Would you ever consider hunting them down for us? We'll reward you properly.
Yes, reward? It's a nice touch, isn't it, Deus Phoenix?
Why pay us when the Abbey would do it for free?
It's complicated. The Abbey is calculating in their deployments, especially where Code Red demons
hey,
are concerned.
Hey, Keel! Happy New Year to you, mate.
They'll only act if they determine
Thank
the
you for the
demon
biddies.
Would cause more harm than the losses they'd incur in battling it. That does seem logical.
But sometimes people have lost a loved one to such a demon. Or sometimes they have a connection to the person the demon used to be. Wherever there's a Code Red demon, you can bet there are people willing to pay good money to have it killed.
And let me guess.
Slay
that's where
demons.
The Bloodwings come
Thank
in.
You, Kill, for the biddies.
Exactly. There are Bloodwings all throughout Midgand who have information on these Code Red demons. If you defeat a demon and report back to my comrades, they'll make sure you're well compensated.
Excellent.
All right, I understand. But I won't make any promises.
That's fine. No sense in drawing up a contract when the hunter probably won't survive anyway. If you get results,
well, rude.
Let us know. We'll hold up our end. That
There's
being
no,
said,
no need for that.
I'd feel guilty if I didn't help out at least a little, so here, take this.
Those Bloodwings are definitely a rough crowd.
To be fair,
Wait, we're
never
not?
That straightforward when you're dealing with demons.
All that matters is that there's something in it for us if we hunt those Code Red demons. The only thing better than fighting formidable foes is getting paid for it.
Just remember that these Code Red demons are
Yeah, these are like special
the
bosses
shiver.
From what I remember.
We'd be wise not to underestimate them.
We should talk to those Bloodwings before considering any of the marks. They might have information that will help us prepare.
Yeah, and we better remember to upgrade our equipment.
Right.
You can use an Enoth bottle. Enoth bottle? Oh, you can teleport to people places. Okay. Nice. I can immerse myself. No problem, Noble. As long as the setting takes itself seriously. That's the key for me.
Hey, Lafayette.
Has to take itself seriously.
What is it, Rokuro?
Mabo Curry.
Huh?
You're an interesting one. You like Mabo Curry that much, huh?
It smells good. And it's creamy and kind of spicy.
Ooh, that sounds nice.
Eating it made me feel nice.
I'd say you love it then. Do all Malakim have such an appetite?
Each has their own tastes. Some eat a lot, some eat a little. Just like humans or demons.
What do you like, Aizen?
Drinks, I suppose.
Booze!
What else?
Pretty much just drinks.
Don't you like anything else?
Is it a problem if I don't?
No. I'm just wondering.
For me, it's drinks and candied sweet potatoes.
That's where you boil strips of sweet potato in oil and then coat them in sugar.
This game's all about
right?
the food.
Yeah, I never get tired of them.
So you like to drink, but you've also got a sweet tooth?
Yeah. Is that so strange?
No.
Candied sweet potatoes. Sounds good.
Oh no, not meal.
You get a lewd.
There's nothing to be ashamed
and
of.
You get a lewd.
It's just a sign
Everybody
that you're alive. Remember?
Lewd. Right.
Holy fucking what? What? T-Nick? Holy crap, man. T-Nick, what is that? 109 in like a few days? You are mad. You are mad. Are you sure that's okay to do? Are you definitely sure that's okay for you to do? That's some. Thank you so, so much, but holy crap, man. Literally everyone is subbed. Holy crap. Damn, thank you so, so much, T-Nick. Only subs allowed. They called me crazy, mad. Wait, they called you Eugene? Why Eugene? Holy fuck, seriously, thank you, T-Nick. Honestly, wow, mate, thank you. Thank you very much. Some folks are obsessed with visual fidelity, aren't they, Noble? Definitely. But I'm certainly not one of them. I can... Again, as long as the game takes itself seriously, I can get into it. If it makes it very jokey, I can't, normally. There's an exception to that rule, but generally speaking. Honestly, T-Nick, holy crap. Thank you so, so much, T-Nick. Damn, dude.
Unarmed? Hardly. These are deadly weapons.
Honestly, mate, thank you so, so much. Well, as long as you're okay and you need that, mate. Or you know, not to be rude, but I'm trying to what's the polite way of putting it. Like, please make sure you look after yourself as well, man. I'm really grateful, and I'm sure everyone is with the gift subs, but like, please make sure you look after you as well. Thank you very much, and thank you, Spookums.
Lewd.
Oh, thank you for the gifts to Emmy and Corvus, Spookums. Sorry, let me just swap these around a minute. Who was it that just mastered? Earthring. Fire ring, nice. Wait, where are we actually going? Find foil the ambush, okay.
You'll be rushed on my throat.
Yeah, don't worry, it's that puts me at ease, T-Nick. That puts me at ease. Honestly, mate, thank you ever so much. You absolutely stellar person, you. Thank you very, very much, mate. And again, thank you, Spook. You guys, honestly, you lot, you're all far, far too nice to me. You really are. I'm just some derpy, dumbass bro. Damn. Thank you very much. Maybe it's on the next one, actually. But yeah, perfect example, Noble, that I can think of is... I can't see an ambush on here. Weird enough, Wildstar? Ah, here we go. Sorry, before I can... Wildstar, right, Noble? It didn't take itself seriously. It was very jokey. It kept breaking the fourth wall. And nothing mattered, and there was no stakes. So I couldn't get into this, like, the universe. I couldn't get into it. I couldn't care that there was a fight or there was a war going on because the game didn't care. Does that make sense? Even though Wildstar at the time was a beautiful looking game graphically, it wasn't... I couldn't immerse myself into it because of it. Whereas Nier, even at the time, Nier wasn't a very great looking game, comparatively speaking. But Nier's story and Nier's, like, care really got me into it. Hey, Archers. No More Heroes does and doesn't. No More Heroes has points where it doesn't take itself seriously, but when it counts, it does. Like, when Travis is talking about something serious, or let's say a character who's about to be killed, let's say Holly, is saying something seriously, Travis doesn't, like, point at the camera and go, like, man, that Holly chick, what a nice ass, or something, you know, like, something out of place. Oh, hey, Holly, Wildstar, yeah, I was about to say. You really liked it, though, didn't you, Wildstar? Teenik, many, many hugs to you, man. Many, many hugs. Emmy gets to join the lewdness. Oh, look! Is this the ambush? Hey, noobs.
Hey! Get out of our way!
I don't mind that Deadpool. There. I don't mind Deadpool. But Deadpool's not a video game, I guess. Weakness to...
Give it up! It's ours!
That monkey's not. Here we go.
No mercy.
There is a Deadpool game. Christ, is that? Was it any good?
So the attackers were demons. I guess that's why they needed us to stop the attack.
It is serious in its own setting. That's exactly it, Tino.
The doctors?
Looks like they ran off.
Look at Aizen's little poison pouch. Very fine.
It appears they were after this stuff.
Holy medicine water? With the cathedral seal.
That scarf. Did that belong to the attackers?
We murdered them.
Yeah. All three were wearing them. Does it mean something?
Quite a few, I think, Tina. Quite a few.
Aggressive ones who attack the innocent.
Oh yeah, we got a titty window. Alright, so we can actually go back and hand in our quest now. But we can also...
The job is done. Time to leave.
Is that growing back over here? Nice. Maybe it hasn't? No, it hasn't. Alright, Velvy, what should we put you in this time then? We've done our little serving clue. Oh yeah, let's go for the summer look for a bit. Sure, why not? With our short shorts. Hey, what this over here? Yeah, it's quite a difficult one because I really have to care about a game world. It's a really difficult one. I can't always tell you why I'm not immersed in a game, and sometimes I am. It's a weird one. Wait, the music's changed. Oh, I left the music on the costume. That's why. The monkey thing with the axe? No, not yet. I have never played Undertale. I've never played Undertale. I've heard good things, but I've never played it. Teenix's a good agony. So for anyone wondering, we've had massive loot bombs from Noble, Spookums, and Teenix over the last 24 hours, I think. So if anyone's curious about this, I'm sorry. And Cypher did some earlier.
Get out of my way.
I want to say we had another loot bomb earlier as well. I need to actually. That's very rude of me. I need to quickly squint. Try to remind myself. It was Salenti. Salenti did one. Jag did one yesterday as well. Arx King did some. Fucking tropical music. Let's not have that. Let's not. Let's say we didn't, yeah. There we go. Alright, so I think we need to go back and hand this in.
I'll end this quickly.
Yours was a baby bomb. No, yours was a legit lewd, like a lewd explosion. A lewd explosion sounds like the kind of thing you need to get like washing powder up. I think they're all nuclear. Like Noble, yours was like an A-bomb. Spookums was also like an A-bomb. And like T-Nix was like the SAR bomber. Right. I think we can squint back down to the tavern. Yeah, so let's go back. How are we finding Velvet's costume? Is it acceptable? It's not. She doesn't wear it very much, to be fair. Have we amassed any gear? I don't think we have in the last little bit, honestly. No. So we're still waiting for a little bit. She does jiggle. Yeah, she does jiggle. Have you beaten Alanelli out already, Noble? Oh,
you're
shit.
The
oh, no. Oh, no, Pumpkin. Have a rest. Pumpkin is an absolute drawing machine.
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull up.
Oh. Honestly, very. I'm never here to tell you what you should or shouldn't do, but you should totally rock the outfit. Say fuck it and just go, like, yep, I'm gonna velvet it up.
By the way. Those folks we just passed were talking about us.
Oh, nice.
What were they saying?
They were saying you
they
need to put a coat on.
They were warning each other to be careful, talking about the demons that burned down Helavies and destroyed the Seagate Fortress being near the capital.
Considering how bold we've been, everyone's still fairly calm about it.
We'll be famous soon enough.
Yeah, the Saw Bomber is ridiculous.
Savior.
Sounds like that could
get fun. Insanely big nuke.
Fun? Why?
The people trying to capture us will put prices on our heads and put up wanted posters everywhere.
Yeah, you want
to depending on who draws the likenesses, each portrait can look completely different. You know what I'm talking about, right,
Eisen? Let's all hug Hi. Pumpkin in a big,
I've
like,
seen
hug pile.
Dozens of pictures of myself. Some make me a monster, others make me a handsome youth. It's fascinating, really.
I hope I get a poster soon.
Aww.
Then do your best to really stir things up.
Right. I'll stir everything up good.
Why is Laffer set so cute? I think there is a skit about Velvet's hair, yeah. I wanna say.
Well, we've learned one thing coming to the capital. The Abbey and Shepherd Artorius.
Yeah, Velvet's outfit was literally whatever was the hand and just tied together.
They might as well be the Empire now. They have the undying support of the populace.
The Shepherd, savior of humanity.
Hug
Bukaki. I wonder what he meant by the blessings of the Empyrean Enominat.
That's what they call the gods they worship in church, right? The Empyreans? He promised a lot in that speech. But can he really command such a power?
I have no idea.
Honestly, Velvet's hair game and eyebrow game is really solid.
Stories and legends. He called Enominat the fifth Empyrean. There should only be four. One ruling each element.
Is he talking about a new Empyrean?
Have you heard anything, Lafayette?
Sorry. I don't know anything about this.
Damn it, Lafayette!
It doesn't matter. We should be careful about taking his words at face value. The man is no saint. He'll stop at nothing to achieve his aims. But there's no way he could have a god at his beck and call.
Yeah, the Saw Bomb is pretty insane, right? And yes, I've played Halo.
Trust me, I'm not. That's why I'm using the Shadow Guild to help us hunt them down. And to make sure that I kill him.
Slay him.
Yeah, I've played Halo 1, Halo 3, Halo 4, Reach. And that's it. What was it? What this? Oh, the shrieking demonic bat. Oh, nice. The creeping viper. Oh, it's lewd. Oh, wait. Hand-holding bot, what are you doing? I see you there, scum. Where is the Gale's Lake Road? If you see Artorias carving for his drops. Yeah, like, remember you get 3 carves on Artorias.
You're good at what you do. I'm impressed.
I actually really liked Reach as well. I want you to destroy goods in red crates stored at a warehouse in Port Zexon. You alright?
There's still more to do. I'm sure it'll be easy for you.
Destroying all right, Noble. Crates in a warehouse? Doesn't sound very nice.
Have we ever been nice?
I suppose not.
This is a contract job, so let's keep costs down. I'll call the Von Eltia and have her draw the guards away.
If you would.
What will we be destroying?
Everything.
Who knows? That's hardly our concern.
That's true. It's only in my hand. It's safer that way, right? Oh, thank you, Cap. Dear Halloween, get in on the friendship and family. Enjoy. I've just been gifted Undertale. Thank you very much, Cap. I have never played that. As I was saying, actually. So I'm looking forward to giving that a go. Thank you very much. Oh, I've been getting some really nice games recently. Port Zexon. Oh, no, we can just beat something shit up on the way, can't we? There's no reason to walk. Yeah, I forgot to end the stream after hosting Roof at DD, and so it streamed all night. Luckily, these guys babysat my stream, so it's all good. You recommend playing it without streaming it? Oh, really? Any particular reason, or is it just a game better done, like, just concentrating or whatever? Let's fuck up these snacks. Come on, snack. Connor the snack.
Don't get over confidence.
No escape!
Oh, nice.
But I'm this close. I want this!
Oh, it's very easy spoiled. Oh, really? Ah, okay. They're a bit unsafe. The people are a bit careless, but... Yeah, thank you so much, Cap. I really appreciate it, man. Thank you. I've even given you some freaking cool games tonight. Thank you very much. Like I was saying earlier, you guys are far, far, far too lucky for me, really. Thank you. I am very, very spoiled these days. Guys are amazing. Oh, fuck off, snakes. Stop stunning my little velvet. My little velvet couldn't possibly be this angry.
We're finished here. Let's go.
The amount of XP you get when you're doing that is actually... Water Snake's Wake? Oh, I don't know what that is. What is Water Snake? Avalanche Fang. Water Snake's Wake. Jumps back before sliding around gracefully, picking up downed enemies. Ooh, interesting. That's all martial arts, right? Yeah. My Mega Sonic Thrust is a bit... whatever. Rising Moon. Let's change Rising Moon to Water Snake's Wake. That's a B. Velvy, have you finished your thing yet? You boys are slow, you need to finish your shit. Okay. Oh, we're going the wrong way? Going the wrong way, that way. Alright, Spookums. Say hi to Ollie for me. You like her outfit? What, Velvy's? Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Velvy's very bouncy as well. Boing, boingy, boingy, boingy. Yeah, Genshin's only 60, isn't it? Which is a real shame, actually. Would be nice if they did higher FPS, but...
You better be ready.
Whoa. Rip. I love that slide at the end. It's great. Why do these snakes always stun me? Lots of ghosting. What's your refresh rate, Max, on your monitor? If you're getting ghosting, it normally means the refresh rate's too not the refresh rate, the response time's too high. You, for a gaming monitor, you want a 1ms response time, normally. Oh, Expedition's back. Hello, magical boat. What did you do? God damn it.
I knew this would be big.
A red jeweled pendant. Rangetsu basic training. Exit room.
Scout ship setting sail.
Oh, we need to cook, don't we?
Food's ready.
Looks like you want to die.
Wait, is it a new Binding of Isaac game? Is it? What's going to be involved in that? Nice. As you can see, linking battles like we are gives us, makes the enemies do way, way more damage and gives them a lot more defense as well. But, Oh, it's the expansion, is it? What, to the existing game? Oh, it's 5ms. That's probably why you got some ghosting on that, mate. You're gonna get a little bit of ghosting on that. Until there's multiple endings, you need to play for multiple times. Alright, okay. I'll have to do it a pop and see. I do know some of the music in the game, though, because it's pretty famous.
That was tougher than I would have.
Biggest fan made DLC. Oh, so it's fan made DLC, so is it free then? Waistcoat. Oh nice. Laffy's done the waistcoat. Let's swap him over then. What have we got in here then? Nothing? Oh, here we go. Amber waistcoat. Let's go. Oh no, I hiss. Try to get done so with little knowledge as possible. All right, I won't look anything up and just go for it like basic bitch. Go that way. Yeah, you and me both, Emmy. We should go get a pun. We should talk to each other about it. Like, yeah, boy. Right, we need to go find a warehouse, don't we? This is Port Zeke's. I guess it's the exclamation mark. Hey, this is the warehouse, right? Maybe not. Oh, it's gonna be one of these. Bound to be. Oh, there's a cat's chest. Let's go have a look. The Outer Wilds. I haven't played Outer Wilds, no. I played Outer Worlds, which was alright. Although, it definitely got weaker towards the end.
Have you heard? The Abbey is building a new base. I hear it's a huge temple in the middle of some mountains near a site of ancient ruins. If they've got time to build a temple, they should use it to kill more demons instead.
You sure Tales music's you amazing, talk about I mean. That here?
Love it. Ha.
I'm different from all those losers who swoon over the shepherd's pretty words.
A peevish boy.
Reality.
Fucking peevish.
No one's found a way to cure demon blight yet, and demons are still swarming everywhere. Sure, maybe things are not as bad as they could have been. But we still have no idea what's going to happen next. Think about
it. You sure, T-Nick? You've already done loads, man.
Demons infiltrating the city as we speak, and we'd be none the wiser.
Yep, you're completely right.
Oh, Velvet's just like, yeah, I agree. Yeah. You explore a micro-universe.
All right.
Okay, that sounds kind of fascinating.
The guards are gone. Let's move in.
Benwick and the crew did a fine job.
All right, let's sneak in here. Destroy the red crates. It's these ones, I guess. All right. I love that we're just vandalizing shit.
Red crates. These must be our targets. The seal of Midgant Cathedral?
Should we look inside?
There's no need. Burn them, Lafayette.
Okay.
Crime, 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 crime! Should
we're
we...
done here.
Should we leave?
Let's go.
Okay, Dinek. Sounds good, man. Thank you very much.
That storm cost too much time. Uh-oh. I must report to Lord Artorias as soon as possible.
Oh no, she's cute.
It's you!
Oh no.
Oh hey, the crybaby.
Ha ha ha.
Eleanor Hume, Exorcist Prater.
Well, I kicked off quickly.
You won't get away this time.
You really want to fight, don't you?
Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try.
I have heard of Jade Cocoon. One of my exes was fascinated with it.
No mercy.
No mercy. She's weak to fire. Humans ill like fire, Arisen. Rip. Yes. She played Jade Cocoon loads and loads and loads.
Willing to fight without your Malakim?
No. You set the storehouse ablaze?
That I did. That was my handiwork.
The people have worked so hard to withstand this time of crisis. How can you destroy what they have so painstakingly built?
What can you do, cry about it?
Because I'm not human.
You'll pay for this, you demon!
More Malakim up her sleeves.
I will protect you, Madam Eleanor! Come and face me now, demon!
He's adorable.
Am I?
Oh.
Ooh, I found you at last. That bad, bad voice! The Enfu, you traitor! You'll never leave my clutches again!
Not her!
No!
What are you doing? Get out there and fight!
He is cute,
Look. Is that smoke?
It is! Fire!
The fire has spread enough. Let's get going.
You're coming with us.
Let me go! Witch
nappers! Madam Exorcist! What happened?
Witch nappers?
Oh, you're badly hurt.
I can wait. Gather the people and put out that fire.
Yes, madam.
Tell me, do you know what was being kept in that warehouse?
Mostly nectar, I believe. Vast stores of the medicine, provided by High Priest Gideon, to be distributed to doctors across the land.
Medicine given by the church? Why would anybody destroy it?
That was Bienfu. I don't know what she's gonna do with it. Good question. Ah, we mastered a load of stuff. Excellent. Unlocks level 2 random skills. Bargain.
Whew. Looks
she
like
puts
we're
it up above,
clear.
Dermarath. It's like a cave up there.
Aww,
poor Muggy Lou.
Well, at least now I know where to find him.
That weird little Moloch was the one you were looking for?
The very same. The Moloch Bienfu! A creature of unfathomable wickedness and beguiling cuteness who broke the heart of this wretched maiden! Once I finally catch him, who knows what I'll be capable of?
Not sure I get it.
Me neither.
Nope.
Good. Pray that you never do. Let's go back and report our success.
Right. What are we doing here? Alright, Velvy. You are gonna sit in... Oh, no. What are we gonna do? Yeah, that looks nice. Let's do that one. And hairstyle. What are we gonna do? Oh, that's nice. Let's do that one. Am I familiar with the artist Tiki? No, I'm not actually. Eleanor does have a big bum. It makes perfect sense. No, no, no!
Here I come.
Oh no, I left the music on again. Sorry. I know we anime now. Oh really, is she Futaba? That's awesome. I still love the Velvet Shante. Retsugo!
Unarmed, hardly.
Right, let's not have that terrible anime music then. If we're gonna fight, you have to come with me. There we go.
I'll end this quickly.
Excellent. Oh, got stunned. Where are the belly dancing velvets? No belly dancing cockfur, is it? That's a shame! Oh my god, imagine if we could get Shanti's outfit velvet. That'd be amazing. Wait, no! I got a better one. Imagine we get Shanti's outfit for Aizen. Oh yes. Oh yes.
Nothing can stop these fists.
Oh wait, I just realized we did some thingies, didn't we? Yeah. Oh, that doesn't matter. Is the blade done though? No. Amber boots done. Ah, nice. Good stuff. There we go. Cool. Learn new shit, please.
Don't waste my time.
The nice thing is, if you link encounters, I'm 99% sure you can basically grind in any area of the game you like, because they always levels up to your level, which I actually really appreciate. Makes it a bit more variety. Shanti and Velvet trade outfits. That'd actually be pretty good. The beige outfit, well, this one. It is nice, isn't it?
If you want to live, get out of my way.
Die, enemy bosses. Oh yeah, those guys are nasty. Normally you have to leg it, I think. Oh, we should cook more. Veli, we need to get you some cooking. Cook some tuna.
Food's ready.
Food's ready. It'll do. Ugh, food's ready. Melt gear and stuff, yeah. I'm really glad to see everyone still really enjoying Tales, I must be honest. I really was worried about streaming this. I really was. I don't know, I thought everyone would be bored to tears. Not because it's a, you know, a bad game, but I just, I don't know. Because I really like these games. I'm happy just to, fuck, just to put along with these trailers, but...
Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try.
Yeah, no worries, Eunuch. I understand that. You don't want to get spoilers, man. Especially in a game like this. No, sorry, Playful, I missed it, mate. Can you repeat it? Pretty tasty. Hey, Sakura. Yo, I also love this game. Hello.
What's the deal with you and that exorcist, Eleanor? She had tears in her eyes when we first saw her at Northgand. Velvet poked fun at her, calling her the crybaby exorcist. Why would an exorcist cry?
Can't escape, has he?
Sacrificing the individual for the good of the many is part of Artorias's philosophy. She seemed troubled by that. She's naive.
That she can still carry on shows just
how strong
she is.
You're getting that now, too.
It looks like they don't hand out the rank of Praetor to just anyone.
Hmm?
Just stay sharp around her. That's all. By the way, is that Bienfu character that Magilu was after really a Moloch? He may look strange, but yes, he's still a Moloch. That means Magilu is an exorcist.
Zesty was
Why did
dull,
she call herself
wasn't
a witch, then?
The combat was great, but Zesty was a bit
in
dull,
prison,
story-wise.
She must have been kicked out of the Abbey.
Or she could be a fraud.
Yeah. Even if she wasn't an exorcist, she could still perform some tricks with a Moloch like that.
I will protect you, Madame Eleanor. Face me now, demon!
Right?
Nice.
Was that laughter?
I'm sorry.
Why apologize? Bianfu is funny, right?
Right.
Then if you want to laugh, laugh!
Aww.
If you think that's funny, you should give it a try for yourself. Say,
hi, I'm Luffyset.
All right.
Hi, I'm Luffyset.
Knock it off.
Huh?
What's the problem?
People are staring. Don't attract attention.
I'm sorry.
She's so uptight. Let's try it together later, Luffyset.
All right.
Velvet, you're so sour. So what I did in the end playful, I went to settings under, which one was it? I want to say it was under output? Yeah, under output, I changed it from max from quality or max quality to max performance. And that fixed it. That fixed it for Yakuza. I left it as a sort of thing there, because it seemed to work. Yeah, that should suss it, Michael, if you do that. Hey, Ritari! Tsundere Velvet, seriously. Yeah, we've got happiness at the moment, and everyone's cheery. It's going to get awful. Honestly, this game just is... There are points in this game for hours on end, it's just absolutely gut-wrenching. It really is. I remember when I played it the first time, I had to take a break every so often, I was like, fucking hell. Oh, hello.
Trouble at the docks, was there? Well, so long as the job
yeah, playful.
Done.
That should fix it, mate. Search for the missing man. Find and bring back a scholar named Mendy, who disappeared along Gallus Lake Road.
Good luck. I look forward to hearing your report.
Isn't that where the snack girl is?
A scholar missing on the road to Gallus Lake.
Yes, strange Emmy, you request. Really should. It's
if
so good.
If they know where he vanished,
Auxilia too
why
was
don't
trauma
they just
as
look
well.
For him there?
Exactly. And what's so illegal about a missing person?
Especially with Jude and Mila.
Go to the underworld.
It's not fair.
I can think of a few possibilities, but our job isn't to ask questions.
Yeah. Velvet's a professional. Right. Isn't Snake Titty on Gallus Lake Road, the yawning wetlands? Okay. Doggy! Nice. I'll make a quick save here in case I snuff it. Auxilia 2 needs to get off the PS3. It really does. That would help a lot. Some Tales games always experiment a little bit with different bits, like mild stuff. Like, I remember Symphonia has a relationship system. You can actually choose who to go on a date with later and who appears in your ending and stuff like that. Obviously, the correct answer for that is Professor Rain Sage. Obviously. Hello.
Don't waste my time.
You only ever play Berseria and Vesperia? Honestly, they're both incredibly good. Takuya, if you really like Vesperia, you'll really, really like Tales of the Abyss. Yeah, I can recommend that heartily. It's on PS2 and 3DS. Both are great versions. Pick whichever one you prefer. Very, very good. Abyss is my overall fave, probably. Abyss has a great love story going on with it. Which, which helps.
I wish I had power like that.
Air thrust. Ugh. Nice. Right. We've done... Is it the... What did we just do? We just mastered something, right? Or did we just loot something? I'm so confused. I swear it said mastery. Oh, it did. Aqua ring. Roku, are you now done with all the rings? I think you are. Alright, we'll just leave that on for now. Then. So we need to find the missing scholar, Mendy. Let's see if we can find him. Honestly, Chibi, Luke has probably one of the best character development and evolutions through most any RPG I've seen. It's really, really solid. He does start out like absolute shit, but he really does get better. To the point where it's a major plot point. The real criminal of Tales of the Abyss is Annis. Fuck Annis. Not literally. Berseria makes you think of bear people. That's all feels like a bear. Nice.
I unleashed all my power.
Alright, I'm not entirely sure where we need to go. Maybe that one over there? Close neck. You'll always, if I can, you'll always see me basically trying to link encounters like this. It always makes more sense to link encounters. Get much more XP. Combat is a bit like that's the nice thing about this area's combat, it's a lot of fun. Honestly, Zesty's combat was also really good. The armorization was really fun. It didn't help. What resolution do you stream at? Try turning the resolution you stream at down a smidge for that game.
Not worth my time.
Zesty DLC? I don't think I ever played the Zesty DLC. Rather than NVEC, try CPU. Try CPU for that. That might help with thingy.
Here I come.
It's sequel baited, though, did it really? Because I thought the ending for Zesty was pretty definitive. Wombat, it was. It was fucked up. Do you want to know the biggest crime when it comes to Tales games? That the two girls in the Tales of Vesperia movie don't show up in the game. They are. Brilliant.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
Enchantress level 2. Interesting. What talent are we using? Damage reduction while guarding increased by 25%. Burn. Damage reduction while guarding increased by 25%. Okay. Combat contestant. Increase the power of art space. That's beasts. What have we got? Soul Taker. I can do better than Soul Taker, probably. Weak point combos. Actually, that's pretty fun. Let's try that. I don't know where we should be going. Let's try up here. If it's free, it might still be blocked off. Nope, let's go up here. No, the main the story of Zesty is boring. I will be honest, I don't care for it. It's okay. I'd a push, but otherwise it's...
Hey, that noisy demon looks pretty strong. Think it might be one of those Code Red demons?
Doesn't matter to me.
Hate is a strong word. I wouldn't say I hate them. I found them a bit boring, though.
I don't see it as a waste of time. Look, the Abbey only has
Noble.
A handful of exorcists strong enough to take something like this down, right?
Oh, Noble,
probably,
dude, that'd be awesome.
I'd say praetors like Lady Teresa and the legates could
probably
take it.
Oh, I totally reckon you should. That'd be really
and
cool.
Those guys are all your enemies, right?
I see where you're going with this. The Abbey is strong, both in its individual members and as an organization.
And if we're to close the gap between us and them, we need to fight strong opponents like this demon.
That's what I would do. but you're free to make your own decision.
Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure this demon's fucking hard as nails, but...
But we should determine just how strong it is first. I don't want us to bite off more than we can chew.
That goes without saying. I'd rather not get myself killed due to inadequate preparation.
You don't have to worry that much. If you want to go fight, I'll help keep you safe myself. I promise.
I don't recall asking for your protection.
Lol.
You don't need to.
Roker is just... he's not fazed at all. Azzy, I don't dislike Zestiria. I think the combat is incredible. I really like it. I just didn't care for the story and the characters particularly.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Shark! Delicious.
Scout ship set.
Right. Oh, we should cook some more. We should always be cooking, actually. Should I auto-cook for a bit? Yeah, let's do that one. With Veli.
Food's ready.
There we go.
I'll finish this.
Nah, I totally get that, Noble. I totally get that. But it'd be one of those things, once you open it up, it'd be cool. You know, it'd just be nice. It'd be, once you get over that little hurdle, you'd be like, yeah, this is fucking great.
We're finished here. Let's go.
Okay, the bag's done. That's good news. So we can move to the amber. Nope, that's done. Okay, cool. Is there anything over here? Let's have a quick squint. Cool. I bet we can slide down here. Maybe we can. Ah, there's the boy with the axe. That's a big lad. We need to come back for him in a bit, though. But... yeah, Persona and SMT games are great. Honestly, good SMT game. Devil Survivor on the 3DS and DS. Really, really, really good.
Not worth my time.
You working better now, people? Hello, Edit. Yeah, tell me the story. That's great. Incredible game. I didn't link any. This is weak sauce. Running it OBS in admin mode.
Worth my time.
Oh, I do that by default. On mine personally, but... Strange Journey was good as well. I'm glad you fixed it though, Playful. That's good stuff. We can't go that way, can we? Because it's misdirect. Let's save it quickly. Yeah, Edit, do it. Depending on how far you got, you know, but it's... Ah, here we go. The Yawning Wetlands. Ooh, it's a new place. With beaver monsters. Batties. Wait, they're not batties, that's a fairy.
I'll finish this quick.
One of these. Weak to martial arts. Oh no, they sound like toads!
I'm the best!
Oh yeah, that's actually a really good idea. Make sure that if you're doing commissions, just let people know that you're going to be a while, so you don't make yourself rush. Anyone who is serious about commissioning art won't be honestly. Like when I commissioned art from like Xena, for example, I always tell her like, you know, take as long as you need to say. Like, it's no problem. Same with when Pumpkin draws art, I'm just like, you know, you just take your time, yeah? It's all good. Silky touch garment. Woven with a unique type of silk, this armor is durable enough and so smooth. Nice. I don't think there's any bad Tails games, particularly, that I've played. Ooh, that too. More damage, less HP. That's pretty cool, though. Let's do it. What's his main skill? Beasts. Okay. Silky. So it's got less defense, but more magic defense. That's fine. Okay, cool. Nice, nice. Alright. Nice. So what are these guys not like? Martial arts. Your emotes are really something else, my guy. Thank you, Eddie. I'm glad you like them. A lot of them were drawn by the very, very talented lady Spicy Pumpkin there in the chat. She's very, very, very legit. So, Eddie, you're a streamer, right? What do you want to be like streaming? Nice. Honestly, two or three swords sounds really sensible. Really sensible. Look at all these friggin'. What do you call these? Weasels? Squirrels? Beavers? Beaver weasels? Weavers? Beavels! Ah, yes, beavels. Fucking beavels. Have none of it, mate. None of this beaver shit. Wait, Edit! I just realised who you are, sorry. I raided you the other day, didn't I? When you were doing your charity stream. Sorry, I was having a brain fart.
I wish I had power
honestly.
Like that.
I'd forget about it if I were you.
How did your charity stream go, by the way? Shadow flow, that sounds very exciting. And we've done the belt and the waistcoat. Oh, very fine. That's what I'd like to see. So the belt, Aphrodite sash. Spoofy. And what else do we do? Natural waistcoat. So we need to do the calico one. Cool. Very fine. This is the Gas Lake Road, right? I'm not being stupid. Yes. So hopefully, yeah, it's actually over here. It's on the next map over. We did, thank you. You raised 20,000. Holy crap. Well, oh, wow, I'm in awe, dude. That's incredible. Well done. Oh, honestly, for such good cause as well, that's absolutely amazing. Well done. Damn, dude. You play Minecraft most often. The other day you set a Pokemon Emerald. Oh, you know, weirdly enough, Emerald was one of the ones I never played. I played a lot. I do like Pokemon. I played a lot of the other ones. Emerald's the one with Rayquaza on the front, I want to say, isn't it? Okay. That was oddly complicated. I played the new Pokemon games when they came out. Was it last year? Boss, wasn't it last year when they came out? Though I actually really enjoyed those as well. Good stuff. So, do you speedrun Minecraft edit, or do you just tend to just, like, you know, just
move
shit,
it or
die. Just regularly enjoy them? Sort of sorry if they're dumb questions. Freaking toads? Rimworld?
Nice!
Rimworld's a really fun game. I never streamed it, I don't think, but I really enjoy playing it. I played it in a while though.
If you wanna live, get out.
Played it with the Lovecraft mod on it, it was really fun. The best thing about it is knowing that H.P. Lovecraft would absolutely hate it.
Oh. Don't waste my time.
Yeah. Tadzor's name comes from one of my RimWorld playthroughs of a lady who kept eating clams, raw clams, and then puking up, and then being really sad about puking up, and they got depressed. And when they got depressed, they ate, and they went and ate more raw clams, and then puked up again. It was wonderful. Oh, ah, I gotta hit the back as well. Let's go. Let's go. A circle of blade. I'm glad to see that DD is repping the lewd emotes. I mean, not that they're lewd emotes, you know, they're just girls in ice cream or whatever, it's fine. If Twitch asks. Oh, hardcore's really good fun as well. Yeah, it's lovely to see you drop in, man. I did lurk a little bit last time I popped in. You have a very, very lovely voice, I must say. You're an absolute joy to watch, you really are. Right, let's pop up. The wholesome emotes.
Exactly.
They're very wholesome. Well, they certainly are on Twitter. I still can't believe they banned my knife emote. The American McGee's Alice knife one. Like, oh, you're allowed to keep all the lewd ones, but the knife, that's just too far. And the F with the tombstone. Sorry, mate, if this has already been asked, but do you record tales for YouTube as well? Vespius, I don't record tales specifically for YouTube. However, I do upload the VODs eventually when I'm stopped being a bit rubbish. So they will be up there if that's any good to you. Yeah, seriously, they nuked the. I forget. I lost a few of them. I lost one of the boys. I had a boy with the boy sickness about belt, and I had the knife. And the tombstone, and I lost all three of them. And Twitch said they were not appropriate and were against the TOS. And I look at my remaining emotes, I'm like, yeah, okay, fair enough, sure. Alright, let's go with that. Every Ahigo they strike down, two more rise up down the road, better. I've got my new lady pumpkin on the job. If I ever lose any, I'm like, Pumpkin, I need some lewd stat. Oh, we lost Venus! You're right, we did lose Venus! Venus Velour from Vampire. Oh, poor Venus. Everybody's gonna drink shots, house rules. Okay. Resistance ring item? Yeah, let's do it. Alright. Okay, so we know over there is a big unit. I wanna say he's the top. She had her aura for show, she did, yes, talk to her. How you doing, Billy Buffer? Mission complete. I hope you had a lovely New Year's, man.
You won't get any pity or compassion from me.
No worries, Vespius. No worries. All right. There's some goodies over here, honestly. Veli, how you doing on the cooking front? Oh, you're almost level 3. Okay. Nice. That's not completely average. Usually I pester you in the DM like, dude, I heard you had some free slots. Let me paint you some emotes like one of your French girls. Yeah, seriously. You're like, I had an idea. What about this? And I'm like, what? A girl eating ice cream? And you're like, exactly. Pumpkin is definitely a fine purveyor, dude. I don't see enough sitting out there. Voichan. What does Voichan look like, though?
They were nothing.
What does Voichan look like? Okay, Veli, you've got 2 cooking levels now. That's really good. So let's turn off auto-cook. Let's cook a twin shark.
Food's ready. It's not-
Veli, why are you so sour about cooking? Adult Seadon. I do like our fish bro. He's pretty good. I want to say that she's absolutely nails, but we're gonna give it a go since we're here. I am gonna be a massive coward and do a quick save though. Voidchan is the best. What does she look like though, Nemo? All right, should we give Lewd Snake Waifu a bit of a stab? Should we see how we fare? It might be fine. We might be about to get bodied. Can I get you from behind?
Are we ready for this?
Oh, I love the music for this. So good. Alright, let's go. I actually have to fight properly for a change. Okay. Right. I think we got it. Some of that sweet. Nice.
Well then, let's move on.
Beautiful. And we did some mastery for that. Very nice. Lovely, lovely. Perfect. She's pitch black with tentacles for legs and bright blue eyes. Oh, that makes sense. I can totally see that. Void Chen. I still love that I didn't end the stream yesterday. I'm such a fucking idiot. I need to do the Aqua Ring. Actually, I swapped them over. I want to say Rokuro needs to do... Yeah, Wind Ring. Veli can't do the, Actually, let's do that. Let's do the calcite boots. Amber waistcoat. Okay, do you need to do waistcoat? No. Natural waistcoat? Ah, natural waistcoat for you, then. Lovely. Calcite bag. Amber bag. Oh, we're done with that. Calcite paper. That's... No. Beast fang. No. No. Okay, I think we're looking pretty good. Yeah, okay. Cool. The longest stream I ever did and I wasn't here for it. I know, it's so terrible, right? Like, oh man. I'm so like... I still can't believe that when I woke up. Whoa, Stan, wait. That's quite the trek, man. You heading anywhere nice? Obviously, don't say exactly where. You know, just, you know. Say internet safety and all that, but, you know, you anywhere nice? Also, again, man, if I don't catch you, I really hope you have a lovely birthday tomorrow, mate. Right. So, I think we need to head all the way south to meet this person we're trying to find. From vacation to back home. Ah, nice. Are you looking forward to getting back? I don't know. I always find towards the end of the vacation that, like, while I enjoy the time out, sometimes it's nice to get home and put your feet up, you know? Right, come on, weavers or beavles. Oh, yeah, beavles. Oh, yeah, beavles. You hate LA? Oh, is that all? You're in Melbourne Fest? I know, I've always wanted to go just to see it. The thing is, America, right? It's always this big, amazing place you see in the movies. Like, whereas I live in like some tiny island nation. But it's America, it's like the land of movies and excitement and shiny things. Sorry, Tini, what do you mean? Like, what's the best way to do this dismantling stuff? I upgrade something to plus 2 or plus 3, and when I'm done with it, I dismantle it. So I get the extra stuff out of it. And then I move on to the next bit.
It's Toad! I'm the best!
The movies are all lies.
Oh, really?
Unarmed? Hardly. These are deadly weapons.
Okay, so you're done with the daggers. So, for example, I would, once I get new daggers, I would break these ones down and then rinse and repeat. I don't, until later in the game, I don't bother, like, upgrading them, like, really, really, like, high for ages and keeping them around or whatever. It's not really worth it. You live in Cali? Oh, that's, LA's in Cali, isn't it? Sorry, I don't know. I take it it's always really hot. I guess it's warm now as well. Wait, Essex in the UK? Oh my god, these fucking snakes. Give me a break, dude. That's like 50 C. I do love me some snow boys, I do.
Come on, really?
Hail's always really cool, right? 43. Ugh, that's mental. Who can be dealing with that? Too hot. Anything above 20 is too hot, guys. Oh, we didn't finish the amber one? Okay. Rubbish. Right, oof, got on my way. No snake. No snake. Only if you come along with fairy.
Move it or die. Too slow.
No mercy. Danger noodles. Only the best kind of danger noodles, right? Oh no. Please stop stunning me. Please stop stunning me. When you get stuck in like a stun lock, that's what it is. Please don't stun the belly. Yeah, like, what music in America? Is it like a lot longer to get to work and stuff generally? If my call needs to work in like 20 to 25 minutes, that's about 6 miles. What's that, like 9 kilometers? Or 3?
Another victory.
Another victory. Delicious. Oh, so the ring's done for you, is it, sir? What should we put you on then? Oh, the void ring. Nice. You like our main woman's modular appendage? Yeah, she's pretty fucking hardcore, right? Alright, Veli, what should we put you in that now? Oh, let's put you in a maid uniform. That seems inappropriate. Let's do it. For 90 minutes! Holy crap. A 90 minute commute is just insanity. I can't even imagine how much of it.
Think you can dodge? Just try. Perfect mayhem!
Mayhem! Splat. As long as nobody minds, I'm going to stream a little bit later tonight because we started later because of Twitch's issues.
I'll cut down anyone in my way!
You missed your 20 minute. I gotta be honest, Arth, I actually really do like driving. I should be all the same. Like, driving's just nice, right?
Take a look at this.
Yay!
Well, well. Now here's a fine haul.
Agreed. Lemons.
Scout ship settings.
Back out you go. All right, Veli. Let's cook and eat some more shark. Shark. Food's ready. Right, so the person we're looking for is down there. So go find him in a bit. Like, I love driving. I find it a lot of fun. So, in the morning, like, people were saying to me, like, oh, moving away from the city, you'll, you know, the longer drives can be a bit of a pain for you, you know, you might hate it. I mean, 2 days a week I work from home anyway, so whatever. But the other thing is, it's just, it gives me a bit of time to unwind in the morning and to unwind in the evening. It's just nice to get out of the car. Yeah, put some music on. I get to listen to some metal, chill out, or Dropkick Murphys. Oh, yeah. Bypassing 2 miles an hour would be shit. Yeah, I agree. That would suck.
I wish I had power like that.
What, a maid outfit? You can. Forget about it if I... Aizen, you can wear whatever you want, mate. Don't let anyone stop you.
Looks like you want to die.
Nice. Fucking Toad. Shut up, Toad! Oh no, son. Oh yeah, audiobooks are really good too, right? I was actually listening to a Discworld audiobook the other day as well. I was listening to Guards Guards. I've actually got a grocery store really close to me, so I'm actually quite lucky. You know I live in the sticks now. The funniest thing, guys, is that living out in the sticks, my internet is better than it was in the city. The downloads are a little bit slower, but the uploads, like, 5 Mbps per hour. Is there AC in Colorado? What's AC, sorry?
That was tougher than
I'm glad you moved away from the silly traffic. You had a commute of 20 minutes, most of which was on a motorway with no traffic. And your office got moved into the city centre, and it's the same distance, but it took 3 times the length. Oh yeah, that's just shit, isn't it? Command shoes? Oh, look at those high heels on that shit. Combat shoes for a lady that provide comfort without sacrificing the design. You know what? I'm going to put those on. And then... Rokuru, you can have... the boots. I would have figured in a hot country like the States, you guys would always have aircon, right? Like, always. Just seems kind of mental, otherwise. Velvet question mark here. It's water, Velvet. You know, water? No? No. I've never had the pleasure of driving on the London motorway. No. The motorway I tend to use is the M4, M5. Or I used to, anyway. Obviously, now I split up with my ex, I don't tend to use it as much.
Who goes there?
What on earth are guards doing here?
Nice maid outfit. What the hell? Exorcist. What have they got? They're weak to water.
Watch out! They've got molecules!
They're no ordinary cell servers.
Made out for his life, yeah. I've been on the M25 before though. The ring race. That's not bad. Snake.
Sheesh. What do you suppose they were guarding?
That made out for his short.
You think they're holding Mendy captive?
Maybe. We should find out. Increases map movement speed by 10%. Ooh, that's really good. Thanks. That's freaking handy. Look at that. We zoomy now. Hey, Franz. Who in the blaze are you? How did you get in here? You didn't kill the mercenary set to watch us, did you? No. No, I didn't kill them. Yeah, M25 is a bit wagging it for you. HVAC. Is HVAC... Out of interest, is HVAC those... You know in Vampire the Masquerade yesterday, we went down into McGee's basement, and in the corner he has like a big tube. Is that HVAC? I'm not trying to run. Yeah, you are. Stop it.
Is there someone here named Mendy? We've come to help.
Oh, thank goodness. I can finally go home.
Hey, Mendy.
So they were keeping you prisoner.
They made you mine vermilion ore?
Yes. I discovered a method of refining it, and it cost me dearly.
What's vermilion ore?
4 hours? Oh, God.
A rare stone made of concentrated nutrients. It can be used in medicine, but it's also poisonous.
Correct.
So you were making medicine?
Yes. They were forcing me to make a nutritional substance called nectar.
Isn't vermilion ore supposed to be highly addictive?
I told them that. But what choice did I have?
Whatever.
Dover the Barnstead, dude.
Can you get back to Logris?
Your driving skills are hardcore.
I can. I'm terribly sorry.
Why apologize to me?
Yeah, Velvet, don't give a fuck.
We finished all the jobs. Let's get back to the old lady's tavern.
Curry.
You sure do like that Mabo curry.
Do I?
Don't ask me.
You didn't think it was tasty, Velvet?
Couldn't tell you.
Aw.
Huh?
Food doesn't hold any flavor for her. According to Velvet, she can never feel sated, and the only thing she can taste is blood.
Oh, I see.
Poor Velvet. She needs a hug. Hug this girl, damn it.
What's the matter? You're gloomier than usual.
Am I actually useful?
Huh?
You can cut down any enemy, and Aizen can beat them up. Velvet is strong and can eat anything.
Chomp.
But I'm not good at fighting, and apparently I'm always gloomy.
Is that what's bothering you?
In a fight, offense alone isn't everything. Hurting your foes means nothing if you don't live to tell the tale afterwards. Your healing arts are what let us always fight at our best.
2,500 kilometers.
Compared to dead weight like Mogilu, you're plenty helpful out there.
Only compared to Mogilu?
I didn't mean it like that. I was just saying she never helped at all.
You're not going to grow overnight. Be patient.
Huh?
You've only just been set free. That you've even managed to keep up with us this far is a feat in and of itself.
I love that these guys are all like big brothers to Luffy.
Strength comes by continually improving your mind and body. Keep your spirits up and keep working at it. And you'll get there before you know it.
I will.
Yay!
The drive to improve is what's important.
Right.
Amazing. Good stuff. Alrighty, I think this is a perfect, perfect place to do a quick save here and stop for this evening. So, I shall leave the stream here, I reckons. Although, I shall park, before we finish, I shall park the wonderful artwork of Pumpkin for Tales of Berseria here. Boop! Oh, there we go. There we go. Nice. So, thank you. Keep the stream on. I will, all night. Yeah, let's not do that. So, again, happy birthday for tomorrow, dude. I really hope you have a good day. I really enjoyed it, DD, and I've done the volcano one as well. That was fun. That was good times. So, thank you ever so much, everyone, for coming along. Thank you very, very much. No 24-hour stream tonight, I'm afraid. No. As much as Void Chan wants to escape, I've locked her in a box for now. She has to stay in there until she knows how to behave. So, take care, everyone. You're all wonderful, wonderful, lovely people. Noble, let me know if you do the commissioning thing. I'm curious, man. And, yeah, I love you all. You're all beautiful. Take care of yourselves. Happy New Year, and I hope to see you all tomorrow. Mwah! Good night, everyone. I'm actually going to hit stop now. It's going to be stopping. Yeah.